The words that we speak are very, very powerful. How many children have become orphans because of a word that was spoken? How many women have become widowed because of a word that was spoken? Families torn apart completely because of something that a man said. Partnerships dissolved and ended after years and years of building that partnership. You find it comes to an end. Friendships completely gone. Years and years of developing that friendship, you find 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, a person knows another man. And all of a sudden that friendship is gone overnight. Why? Because one of them said something to the other. How many of us know of examples of this in our lives? Our tongues are literally a serpent if we don't harness them in. And if we don't harness what comes out of our mouths, you will find that you will cause the deepest of cuts in a human being's heart with the words that you speak. And this is why the Arab poet says, جراحات السناني لها التيام. The cutting of the swords, there is a healing of that wound that will come about. So you will cut the person, yes, and there will be a healing at the end of it, and that wound will go away. وَلَا يَلْتَامُ مَا جَرْحَ اللِّسَانُ. And it does not heal that which the tongue cuts. When you cut a person with your tongue up, then wallahi, that person in most cases will not forget. They may forgive. They may decide to let it go, but they will not forget. Because your tongue is something that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. The one who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day, فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا. So let him say a good word, أو لِيَصْمُتْ, or let him keep completely quiet.